But meantime, let's speak about ICICI Securities, which also delivered its fourth quarter numbers. Revenue from operations higher by 17%, profit after tax higher by 28%, brokerage revenue up 26%, and distribution revenue up 3%. But brokering revenue, most importantly, is seeing growth after six consecutive quarters of a decline. So let's bring on board Mr. Vijay Chandok, MD and CEO of ICICI Securities. Mr. Chandok, thank you so much for joining us today. You know, COVID-19 has been an unprecedented event, but despite this, you managed to report a profit growth of 28%. What contributed to this?
If you really look at our business model, is significantly digital. I think in many ways that has been a very important aspect that one has to keep in mind. Secondly, you know, when we think about COVID-19 and the way in which this has impacted our environment and various companies operating in this environment. Companies have been impacted by supply chain issues. Companies have been impacted by lockdown and inability to simply operate. Companies have been impacted by demand shrinkages. Companies have been impacted by receivable challenges. If you really look at the way our business model is constructed, apart from the fact that it is a significantly digital business model through our platform called ICICIdirect.com, we being a part of essential services have been operating right through. Number two, if you look at the construct again, we are a company which is completely unimpacted by any supply chain disruptions because we don't carry any physical inventory at all. Likewise, when you deliver, you know, even e-commerce companies are struggling to do the last mile connection. We don't have such challenges because our delivery is again electronic. So we completely are able to deliver our services without a need for an interaction interface or a physical connect at all. It's a digital way of engaging. We also need to keep in mind that the way we are constructed, we do not have a receivables challenge because typically the customer pays us first and then, you know, he goes through the transaction. So receivables is not an issue, inventory is not an issue. We are a cash generating company. We virtually carry no leverage. We virtually carry no credit risk. So we have to keep these factors in mind, which has helped us in current times.
Okay, you know, from the different segments that you're present in, which segment will be your focus area for growth?
So, you know, at times of this current, in the current situation, a lot of our focus continues to be significantly digital, digitizing the stuff that we can digitize, okay? We need to keep in mind the fact that this has given us an opportunity to think about various processes that can be digitized, and that's what our increased focus is, because the way again the market has is for us, it is in any case a high operating leverage kind of a business model, and our ability really is to access various segments of the market that exist without any incremental, you know, costs. So we will be we are in many ways opened our business model, digitized it significantly, so that every segment of the market that is possible for us to harness and tap, we can do that. Without any sort of delta, you know, costs because of the nature of our business model. So we would be focused in that sense on digitizing and improving processes and improving customer experiences. And the consequences of that will translate into our ability to harness every segment of the business model that is, or every segment of the customer rather, which is there in the marketplace and which is active at that point in time in the marketplace.
So you've added a good number of clients in Q4. Now lockdown has effectively, you know, said to increase the participation in the sector. Did you witness higher traction in the months so far?
I think there has been an increased participation in the market in the last month of the quarter. And when you actually get behind the skin of this participation to understand the fabric of this participation, I think there are broadly three families of customers that we are able to see with our company. First is a segment of customers who are what I call them the regular traders, you know, people who are frequently there in the market virtually daily, and you know, they are taking their respective positions on a day-to-day basis. What they find is that suddenly the market has become volatile, suddenly things have changed, suddenly their assumptions have gone awry, and there is a need for them to be even more active than before to, you know, sort of change and take new positions that you know, they believe are the right positions for them to take. So they are they typically tend to be active before. In a usual scenario, they get super active in a situation like this. Then you have a set of customers who are, you know, you call them the typical investor, who's built a portfolio systematically with the help of his research. He's not a frequent player in the market, but he watches the markets very closely, watches the economic developments very closely, and he takes his calls and then enters the market from time to time. Now, this person suddenly realizes that his portfolio has, you know, whatever he's been holding has again gone topsy-turvy with the changes that have taken place so dramatically. And he needs to sort of get active into the market to do something about his existing position and probably even take new positions. So this segment of occasional active customer has become, you know, super active in the current situation. Then you have a third segment of customers who always wanted to invest in the market, but they always felt this is not the right time, and they, you know, wait for better times. And in the meantime, if you sort of go back into the recent past, even 3-4 months back, you know, markets from November to January, you know, sort of went up quite significantly, and these segments of customers realized that they've, in a way, missed the bus. So suddenly the fence sitters, if you can call them that, they jump into the market because they are seeing stocks at multi-year lows, and they think that this is a great opportunity. So you have all the three guys, the regulars, the occasional investors, and the fence sitters, all jumping into the fray. And that's the reason why we are seeing more active sort of traction and participation. Well, you know, you've asked about how things are in the month of April and May. May, of course, has just about started. So, you know, let me just give you a color on how things are we've experienced in the month of April. I think the trends have continued to be similar to what we've seen in the previous month. Activity levels are quite higher than the usual trend. Probably the fact that people are sitting at home, you know, this is one more place to keep themselves also occupied. Probably that is also adding to the activity in the marketplace. But indeed, marketplace is a lot more active, and the trend that we've seen in the month of March continued in the month of April as well.
Thanks so much, Vijay sir, for taking our time for us. Always good to get perspective from you. On that note, we are taking a break. Coming back quickly.